Hey, what's up, New Hope Community Church youth and young adults? Welcome to our living room. We're going to be playing a game for you, and my name is Patrick.
What's your name?
What? Kyle. It's Kyle.
Chloe.
And?
Rachel.
And we are the Machados minus two boys. And so we're going to be playing the game with two balloons. All right, Team Blue here, Team X Blue. All right, I'm gonna blow it up. Kyle's gonna use it as a gun to push the cups over. First team to get all their cups off the table wins. And so we're gonna go with, this is Kaya the ninja and Chloe the giraffe. And we're gonna win. You guys are not gonna win.
Not a giraffe.
You're a giraffe. Okay. All right. So let's get after it. Okay. Ready? Set. Go. The message. We love you. Have a great week. See you next time. Hey, what's up, New Hope Community Church youth and young adults? Welcome to my home. My name is Patrick Machado, and we're going to be jumping into our Bibles. And so we have our new series, which we started last week. It's called Untold Stories. And this week, we're going to be coming out of 2 Kings 2, 23 through 25. So as you turn your Bibles to 2 Kings 2, 23 through 25, let me give you some backgrounds of what is happening before this. The prophet Elisha has just watched his mentor ascend into heaven. He just watched someone he loves. He just watched somebody that he looks up to. The person he was willing to just follow for the rest of his life, leave him. And as epic as it would be to watch someone ascend into heaven and not have to go through death, it still saddened him, it still hurt him, it's still something he was dealing with. And then we jump into our scripture, and it reads in 2 Kings 2, 23 through 25. It says, Elisha left Jericho and went up to Bethel. As he was walking along the road, a group of boys from the town began mocking him, making fun of him. Go away, Baldy, they chanted. Go away, Baldy. Elisha turned around and looked at them, probably with the stinkiest eye he could make, and he cursed them in the name of the Lord. Then two bears came out of the woods and mauled 42 boys, 42 of them. From there, Elisha went to Mount Carmel and finally returned to Samaria. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for today. Thank you that we're alive, that we're breathing, and that we're able to gather here, even if it's online, to hear your word. So may we lean into what you have for us. May we draw out the gems. May we pull out the wisdom and apply it to our lives so that we are not the same today, tomorrow, but we are going from glory to glory and continuing to grow as people of God. We love you. Pray this in your name. Amen. You know, again, just by looking at me online, you might not tell, but I love ice cream. I love ice cream. I love sherbet, you know, and I say sherbet, but I'm pretty sure it's some other word, but most people do, right? And I love Dave's ice cream. Like, being from Hawaii, I grew up on Dave's Ice Cream. They're closing down some places, but they're still out there. And just being from Hawaii, I love all the flavors like pineapple, kulolo, ube, and my favorite, which my wife bought from Safeway, and it's in the fridge, lychee sherbet. And the crazy thing about ice cream too is you always see it in the movies when there's a girl going through her feelings, right? There's a breakup or a fight with her friend and you see her just eating ice cream. I just wonder what it would be, like if those 40 young men had something to go to, if those 42 boys had somewhere to go to, if Elisha had somewhere to go to, if they had something like Dave's ice cream to turn to, right? Would they have not killed 42 guys with two bears? Would those 42 boys not made fun of Elisha? Would nothing have happened? But all kidding aside, 42 boys did know that Elisha was a prophet, that he was a voice of God, right? That he would speak to people on behalf of God, that he was meant to be respected, and that they know about Elijah and that he is no longer with Elisha. And so they fully took advantage of making fun of him because maybe they felt that we'd rather have Elijah than Elisha. We'd rather have the guy with hair than no hair, right? And then Elijah in his feelings, probably hurt and missing his friend and his mentor, lashed out against these 42 guys. But in the same way, it went down. They ran their mouths and they paid the cost. And I was thinking, what is some wisdom we can draw out of this story? What are two things, and I think there is two things that in this season that we can learn, that if Elijah and the boys were focused on, they wouldn't have had this kind of interaction. And if there was only a way for them to be saved from it, something that they could rather focus on a mentor and focus rather on missing out on a prophet and wanting another prophet, a way to avoid coming to bears killing. So with that, the first point is going to be thankfulness over missing out. Man, thankfulness over missing out. 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18, it says, "Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." Thankfulness over missing out. Now, Paul the Apostle is saying there's joy always now. Now that Jesus has arrived and now that death is defeated, rejoice. Be merry, right? Jesus lives. Followed up with talk to him. Talk to Jesus. Pray. Look to the Spirit of God. Look to the Father. Not that we just say yes to Jesus at a camp or maybe an Easter service, we say yes, and then that's the last time we talk to God until we feel like we're dying or in trouble. No, daily, without ceasing, continuously, we are talking to God. And then it says to be thankful. And Jesus wants you and I to be thankful. That is his heart, that is his will for us, that our thankfulness would come. And what I found, right, that comes with thankfulness, it allows for clear vision for your life. When you're thankful, man, it's so much easier to see what God has won, what God wants for you. It's so much easier to see the good in our life because we are thankful for what we have. Our minds, right thinking is possible. When we're thankful, we're thinking clearly, so we think in the right ways. We're not thinking about all the negativity and the bad and the gloominess of today. No, we're thankful for the goodness of today. It deepens memories. It allows us to like look back and think of good times. It's crazy that it happens that way. And righteous actions. You do things, right? You do good things. You do righteous things when you are thankful. You're not trying to hurt anyone. When I'm stoked about good things, it's like that's when I want to hurt someone or I want to hurt myself. No, because you're so focused on being thankful for what God has blessed you with that you're not consumed with what you're missing out on. I remember being a kid, and there's not a lot of things I can remember about being a kid is because It was a long time ago, and I have a poor memory, but I do remember, I couldn't find it, but there's a picture of my uncles, and they're sitting in a Power Wheel monster truck. If you know what Power Wheels are, you might have saw the Barbie Jeep or the Cadillac before. But for me, I had a monster truck, and this monster truck was Bigfoot, and I'm going to be putting a picture up on the screen right now of what it looked like. And imagine a fully grown adult, probably in his, I don't know, mid to late 20s, sitting in this thing that's meant for a 3 to 4 year old. And I don't remember a lot of things again, but for some reason, I remember a monster truck, Power Wheel. I remember my uncle sitting in it. And I remember being in a place that I remember living in my Pahu, where it was a poor neighborhood. And I think the reason why I remember this is because of thankfulness. I know that as a family, we didn't have much. I remember growing up, you know, we didn't have a swimming pool. We had buckets with water in it, you know, those kind of things. But I do remember what I was blessed with and the things that I was able to have as a child. And something like a Power Wheel monster truck seems unfathomable for a poor family, but I had one. And I think Paul the Apostle is saying, hey, find thankfulness in everything. Find the thankfulness in today, because there is meaning in that. And one of the greatest things, like best thing ever, is that we live today. If you had to live back then, it'd be so much harder than today. We have technology, we can meet, you know. I think we're talking about it in a staff meeting, that imagine if there was this pandemic happening right now, there would be no church online if there was no internet. Like, there are so many things that we have today that we are blessed with, and that's why to be on this side of Jesus dying and going to the cross is unmatched. There's an unmatched act of God making a way for freedom, that Jesus is making a way for forgiveness, and that reconciliation between mankind and God is the reason why we should be so very thankful that we can honestly just pray to God saying, God, forgive me. God, thank you. We can instantly talk to him. Back then, there was no way. And so with that, I want to go to our point two, which is forgiveness allows us to escape the bears of life. Forgiveness allows us to escape the bears of life. All right. Paul states again, saying this to the church in Rome, for while we were still helpless, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. He died for you and I. For one will hardly die for a righteous man, though perhaps for the good man, someone would dare even die. Like, we wouldn't die for just anyone. We'd probably die for people that matter to us. But God demonstrates his own love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Right? And even when we are sinful, even when we make mistakes, God lays his life down. It doesn't say God lays his life down for the good and not for the bad. He says, for humanity, I lay my life down. And if we look back in the Old Testament, people were dropping dead because there was no ultimate forgiveness. You see people, person after person, just passing away and dying because there is no forgiveness, right? We see Lot's wife simply looks back in disobedience and is turned into a pillar of salt. We see Uzzah dies from touching the ark, and he was only reaching out to it to stop it from falling over or tipping, which was a violation of the law. From fires, lions, plagues, hail, there was no forgiveness. And I don't say this so that you walk around with this unreasonable fear of God, where, yes, it's good to have a healthy fear of God, because from that we find wisdom. But we shouldn't walk around just like aimlessly living out through a fear of God. But we should be walking in joy, of forgiveness given to us by God through Jesus. That we should live our life stoked about today. That, man, I have forgiveness, so then I do. I have forgiveness, so then I forgive. I have forgiveness, so then I am excited about today. What was meant for us was judgment. What was meant for us was death, and yet we have life. And that's why I say it goes back to thankfulness again. Thankfulness allows us to see forgiveness and when we need to receive and even give it to others, right? When we need forgiveness, it is there. That's why I'm thankful. When forgiveness is needed to give others, we give because it's been given to us. And it's just this crazy, wonderful cycle that happens where it's thankfulness leads to forgiveness and forgiveness leads to thankfulness. This is a lesson I pulled from this is because imagine if there was forgiveness from Elisha. That, yeah, those guys are probably hurting just like me. So I forgive them and I won't send 42 bears. Or, man, I'm so thankful for Elisha. Imagine if we didn't have an Elisha or an Elijah. Those 42 boys wouldn't be teasing him, hey, Baldy, get out of here or be sent up. Why don't you go with Elijah? No, because they're so thankful to have a prophet that's God's still with them through this man. The focus of thankfulness and forgiveness will allow us to circle in and nail what God is trying to do in our lives because we're focused clearly on what he's saying. We're lifting our eyes off the bad and onto the good. And so I love that that is happening. And so please continue to do that. I hope everyone continue to pray in Psalms 51 over your life and how that is important to wash your soul and your body with God's word. And well, that's everything I got. And let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for today. Thank you that you continue to be who you are. Continue to pressing into our lives and sharing your wisdom with us. Thank you for Elijah and the 42 boys and the bears for allowing us to learn from there and their wisdom. And may you continue to bless everyone. May they have an awesome week this week. And we love you so much and pray this in your name. Well, I just want to say thank you again for joining. If you want to know other messages, you can click any of the tabs here. And yeah, if you want to connect with us, you can check us out at newhopecommunitychurch.tv. And that's our website. Or you can see us on Instagram at nhcc.yya. That's where I'll be. That's where our youth ministry will be. And yeah, love to connect with you. Reach out. Email me at Patrick at newhopecommunity.tv. All right, that's my email. And love to connect with you. Well, thank you again for joining, and I'll see you next week.